The playoffs are here in the Champlain Valley Athletic Conference, starting with three games on the high school hardwood tonight. For the Saranac Chiefs, the second season was good to them last year, winning Section 7 before sending themselves to the state's Final Four. While the season ended two games short of the ultimate team goal, a championship, that doesn't mean they aren't shooting for the same end result a month from now. Of course, they're not going anywhere near the state tourney without a win at home against Saranac Lake. First, that was who they had tonight. We pick it up in the third quarter. Kayla Knapper fights through the deep, finds Summer Glepsy running the floor, laying it in. She had a lucky 7 points on the night. 12-point lead for Saranac, but that would go away. Inbound to Jenny Ward just before the quarter expires. Redstorm chipping away, now within nine. Fourth quarter, Storm keep coming. Nicole Viscardo drives to the rack. That's good for two. Lead is down to six for the home team. Luckily for the Chiefs, the shooting drought would end. Emma Newell, 4-3. Corey Trim adds one as well. And the 2012 champs are moving on to the conference semis.
Tonight we struggled a little bit early on. Offensively, finishing around the basket, but kind of settled down later. And give credit to Saranac Lake. They're a very physical, strong team. But definitely the team effort and the defensive concept of just playing every possession has carried us to this point.
It's a great way to start the playoffs. Our team's one of the most unselfish teams. I looked up to all the seniors last year and how far they got, and we want to do the same thing this year.
The defending Class B sectional champions move on and will now get Beekmantown, the 2 seed, on Friday night. The other Class B quarterfinals first round game had NCCS at Peru. Pick it up in the fourth quarter. It was exciting. Down one, Taylor Rabideau takes it down the right side to the hole. Good for two. NCCS goes in front. Back and forth throughout. Mary Mazzella takes it to the left side. Throws up the good shot. It's good for two. Again, a one-point game now for the Indians. Trailing 41-38. Mazzella, this time from behind the arc, knocks down the three. Ties the game. We're 41-all. Cougs not going away. Up two. Jordan Dominic to Allie Cartier. The long two from the corner. NCCS has a four-point lead late, but after narrowing the gap, 30 seconds to play, one of the best three-point shooters in the league is Bree Hackett, dead on. Six threes in the game. Her Indians go up for good and survive to play on.
Great high school basketball game. Both teams played tough. It was a battle. You know, Northeastern Clinton fought the whole way. Our girls never lost their composure. They stepped up, hit big shots down the stretch, and played smart.
We were excited. We were excited to get the W and excited to advance.
And that was in sectionals. That's all that matters. You just have to win. So that's what we did.
Congrats to Peru. Their prize, they get the number one Plattsburgh Hornets at Northeastern Clinton on Friday night. Andrea Rich led the Ty Sentinels with 23 points, the same amount as their entire opponent, as they get the Class C win tonight. Ticonderoga now gets top seed All Sable Valley at Beekmantown High on Thursday.